الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وفي الرواية كل دلالة في النار أيها الأحبة الكرام كيف تطلب العلم How to attain knowledge أما بعد عباد الله فإني أوصيكم ونفسي بالتقوى الله علي بالقدر إخوة الإيمان إن الله تبارك وتعالى مدح العلماء في كتابه العزيز فقال يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله بما تعملون خبير سورة المجادلة الله سبحانه وتعالى praise those who has the knowledge that Allah سبحانه وتعالى exalts the degree of higher estimation درجات العلى those who have knowledge and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is knowledgeable and who is act on them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul shahida Allahu annahu la ilaha illa huwa wa huwa al malaikatu wa ulul ilma qa'iman bil qist la ilaha illa huwa al aziz al hakim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take witness he subhanahu wa ta'ala on his nafs and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also taking a witness of malaika angels and also those people who has the knowledge. فَانْظُرُ أَخِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كَيْفَ جَاءَ الْآيَاتِ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى ثُمَّ مَلَائِكَتِي ثُمَّ أَحْلِ الْعِلْمِ وَنَاهِكَ بِهَذَا شَرَفًا وَفَضْلًا وَجَلَاءً نُبْلًا. That this how important is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention his name Allah Ismullah al-Azim Allah that Allah himself take oath for his name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also take oath with his angels malaika and the same time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take oath those who has knowledge among mankind. So this indicates that how important a human being would be if he attained knowledge. It's important. So knowledge is important. And then because the Islam, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he received the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what the first command was there, tiqra' But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought his last messenger. So what he said, Ma ana biqari, I'm not a reader. He did not know how to read. A Nabi al-Ummi, an unlettered prophet. Unlettered prophet doesn't mean uneducated. We have many people who has a learning disorder, but is very highly educated. Unlettered doesn't mean that he is uneducated. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is extremely highly educated. This is a very, very popular rhetoric. People sometimes say out of ignorance. Be careful. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, highly educated. Without highly educated being he was, how he interpreted Quran, how he interpreted the matters of the dunya and the akhirah, how he conveyed the message of science of embryology, how he conveyed the message of the physics, how he conveyed the message of many physical beings in the world, many the process of creation is a matter in 1400 years before, how he conveyed the message of the genesis, the source of creation of human being. He is not uneducated. He is unlettered. Nabi al-Ummi, but he is extremely educated. Subhanahu wa ta'ala created Ba'as al-Ummi Nabi. So he is unlettered because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him education from him. So the education became a very deciding factor. But it is not only the education from book, because he also did not know how to read, but he got education. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his importance in his book that فَقَالَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنْ قَائِلٍ سُورَةِ الزُّمَرِ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Is it equal, those who knows and those who doesn't know? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like insensitive of the educational status. Sometimes we understand, a brother is very good brother, but that good doesn't make equal. We have many brothers here. The brother next to you are not equal. In terms of what? In terms of ilm, the knowledge. That is the parameter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in his book. هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Those who know, those who don't know is equal? It's not equal. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كَيْفَ يَسْتَوِي الْعَالِمُ وَجَاهِلُ وَالْعُلَمَاءُ وَالْعَامِلُونَ وَهُمْ أَخْشَى اللَّهِ لِلَّهِ غَيْرِهِمْ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is created among mankind. A scholar, meaning is who attain the knowledge. كما أخبر ربنا تبارك وتعالى في القرآن الكريم إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير. Those who have the most taqwa, and then they are more honorable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So attainment of the higher status to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala depends on how much taqwa you have. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep going on the importance of the knowledge. This knowledge is divided in the worldly knowledge, ilm al-dunya wa ilm al-akhirah. Ilm al-akhirah is more important because it is the matter of forever. Ilm al-dunya is for transient period, also not ignored in this dunya. But ilm al-dunya, there is an error. There is an error, trial and error basis. There is a possibility observation make a error. The example is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he migrated to Medina from Mecca, he saw that the people of Medina put a carton around the date palm tree. So that carton made of gnats. So he said, what are you doing? Because he said, Ya Rasulullah, we used to cover the pollination, the flower of the date palm trees on the top, so they will harvest, they will grow the dates. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam make a observation and a personal decision. Don't cover it. So they did not cover. That year harvest was very low. So he, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
during the error and the trial, he was not good in the decision. Because that was ilm al-dunya. Ilm al-dunya, there is a possibility you may enter into the trial and error. But there is no scope of the ilm al-akhirah. You have no chance and space to make any mistake. That what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companion, that what I convey to you about the ilm al-akhirah, it is absolute truth, al-haq. And what I say about dunya, also you pay attention what it is. Because observation can lead to a mistake, an observational mistake based on trial and error. Is also fi dunya, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this dunya as a trial. This life is a trial. Something we assume and something may not happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his messenger, and this messenger tells فَقَدْ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ مَنْ يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wish to do good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the knowledge of his religion. Muttafaqun alayhi. Wa mafhumuhu anna min lam yurid Allahu bihi khayran la yufaqihu fi din. If Allah does not want, does not wish a good for you, then Allah will not give you knowledge of religion. Very simple. Many brothers, they are feeling a fraud, an idiotic fraud. They say, I don't know anything. So you have to repent. You have to make thinking. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he wished to do good a person, he gave the access to religious knowledge. And you are proud of it, that I don't know anything about religion. You should be feel shame. Because that indicates very clear in the hadith, مَفْحُومُ أَنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا لَا يُفَقِّهُ بِالدِّينِ. وقال البخاري رحمه الله تعالى في الباب العلم قبل القول العمل. Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله تعالى, the famous muhaddith, he made a chapter, and in this chapter he titled that العلم قبل القول والعمل. Get to know before you speech, before you act. What happened in our community? There are a group of da'iyah. They come to the masjid, not knowledgeable, and they start talking. Oh, do this, that Allah will make your deen very easy. There is a 170 days, you go with these, that, do. What you are talking about? Imam al-Bukhari wrote a chapter, before you speak about religion, you need to know. Without knowing, you cannot talk. Second is, you cannot act. So the deciding factor is the knowledge, attainment of knowledge. علم قبل القول والعمل. لقول الله تعالى فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعْلَمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. No, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. So the La ilaha illallah is not a matter of saying. Because Allah says in his book, fa'alam, saying and knowing is different, apple and orange. You need to know the condition, the pillars of the La ilaha illallah, the which will nawaqid al-iman, which will destroy your iman, will take you out of your religion. You need to know. Then you need to know the condition of La ilaha illallah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending the knowledge through his messenger, فَبَدَ بِعِلْمٍ. So start with knowledge. وَأَنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ هُمْ وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. That Anbiya left the inheritance of knowledge. The basic difference between الشِّيَعَ تَعَلِي and the Sunnah, أَحْلِ Sunnah الْجَمَاعَ. What is the basic difference? They believe that the prophecy transmitted through blood relation. We don't believe that. We believe that prophecy leads to knowledge. The prophet left, he left knowledge. So inheritance from the prophecy is not well, is not the blood connection, is not the material, it is the knowledge. That's the basic difference, because that's the fundamental difference. Shia and Ahl Sunnah al Jama'ah, they bifurcated two ways. One, they are thinking the inheritance of the prophecy comes to his genetic chain. No! No linkage. The inheritance of the prophecy through the knowledge, and that is continuing until now. وَرَسَهُ الْعِلْمَ مَنْ أَخَذَهُ أَخَذَ بِحَزِّ وَفِيرٍ. And who has hold the knowledge, he hold a good fortune. وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَتْلُبُ بِهِ عِلْمًا سَحَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And those who seek the path of knowledge, Allah will make easy for them to go to the path of Jannah. وَقَالَ جَلَّ ذِكْرَهُ إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهِ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Those who have the knowledge, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. They don't understand it except those who have knowledge. وقال تعالى وقالوا لو كنا نسمع او نعقل ما كنا في اصحاب السعير. The people will go to hellfire, ashab al-sa'ir, the blazing fire. They will make a psychological repentance, that if we have taken the knowledge, if we had na'qilu, if we had used our the thinking process, and if we would listen to the knowledge. Number one, nasma'u. We have to listen to the knowledge. And if we would have understand the knowledge, na'tilu, nasma'u, ma kunna fi ashabi sa'ir, we would have not been here in this hellfire. So the knowledge make the deciding factor who will go to the hellfire. Also, is a belief and also knowledge. And what is the method to gain the knowledge? وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما العلم بالتعلم تعلم إنما العلم بالتعلم. The knowledge will come persistent learning process. It will not come automatic. The giving money, sitting car, eating roast and the chicken will not come to knowledge to you. You need to sit down and study. إنما العلم بالتعلم. So you persistently your knowledge. وَقَالَ إِبْنِ عَبَّاسِ كُونُوا رَبَّنِيًا حُلَمَاءَ فُقَاهَاهَا وَيُقَالُ رَبَّنِي الَّذِي يُرَبِّ النَّاسِ بِالصِّغَارِ الْعِلْمِ قَبْلَ كِبَارِهِ. Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he's saying, رَبَّنِيٌ, who are faithful to his Lord. حُلَمَاءُ, they are the patient. فُقَاهَاهُ, they are the knowledgeable. And then most Rabbaniyun is that who teach the people little thing. So the teacher should teach them bisigar qabla kibar. Like a small matter first, then the big matter. So this is important. Then you have to work hard. You go. There is an example in the hadith, Rawahu Tirmidhi an Qais bin Kasir. قد قدم رجل من المدينة على الأبي الدرداء وهو دمشق فقال ما أقدمك يا أخي. So there is a man who came to Medina to Damascus, and he met Abi الدرداء, and he said يا أخي. فقال حديث بلغني أنك تحدثه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why did you come here? A journey of a month with the camel is more distance from the New York to almost like a California. Is very easy to go by fly from Mecca to Damascus. He went on the camel or on foot. We don't know how he went, but it took a long time. Then he met Abi Darda and he said, my brother, why did you come? He said, I came because hadithun balagani. One hadith, not a hadith, He came from the Medina to Damascus to learn one hadith. Hadithun. One hadith. Qala ama ji'ta li hajati. Did you come for any other reason? Qala la. He said no. Qala ama qadimta li tijarati. Did you come for business? Because you travel a lot. Qala la. Qala ma ji'tu illa fi talabi hadha al hadith. I came to gain one hadith from you. Travel 1 month's distance from Medina to Damascus. One hadith. Do you spend to need to know hadith for 1 month you travel? Nobody will do that. Hadith is everywhere. There are lectures going on in the masjid. Nobody comes. There are books printed in the store. Nobody buy. So nobody pay attention. They are with the dunya. Then Abi Darda reported, Samitu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul man salaka tariqan yabtaghi fihi ilman salaka Allahu bihi tariqan ila al-jannah wa innal malaikatu la tad'u ajnihataha ridaan li talib al-ilm wa innal 'alima la yastaghfiru lahu man fi as-samawati wa man fi al-ard hatta hitanu fi al-ma'. So he's saying that the fish in the water make dua for those who seeking knowledge. Then the dwellers of the heaven and the earth, they make dua for the knowledge. So this knowledge is very, very important. How do you attain a knowledge? So there are two points. Inna litalbil ilmi jumlatan min adab. يَنْبَغِي عَلَى مِنْ طَلْبِ الْعِلْمِ أَنْ يَتَحِلِّ بِهَا فَإِلَيْكَ هَذِهِ وَصِيَّةِ وَالْأَدَابِ فِي طَرِيقِ الطَّلْبِ لَعَلَّهَا أَنْ يَنْفَعَكْ بِهِ. There are certain amount of etiquette seeking the knowledge. We seek the knowledge should follow. And we will give you this advice and etiquette seeking the knowledge. 10 points. Remember, 10 points. Number one, الصبرٌ. When you seek knowledge, you should patience, where do not fast. This heights of persecution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul ya ayyuha alladhina amanu isbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu wa attaqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. The success in the striving to path of Allah and the guard his territory, rabit, stationing army units permanently in place, seek, require the patience. If you are patient, learning process will be successful. Number two, al-ikhlas al-amal, that when you have a purity of intention, it is not showing off, love, making oneself, because there will be some people who will seek knowledge, compete with the scholar. There are people who are learning some shaykh, and then he will compete. He will say, oh, you are not correct, you are not do that. Man talaba qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man talaba al-ilma, yujariya bihi al-ulama. أولي عمارية به السفحاء أو يسرف به وجه الناس إليه أدخله الله النار. Those who seek knowledge in order to compete with the scholar, prove himself, I am ignorant and you are knowledgeable, I know better than you, Allah will cause him to hellfire. So ikhlas is important. Then عمل بالعلم, you should act what you know. That's also requirement number three. And then number four, always beware, Allah is watching. Dawam al-muraqabah. Al-muraqabah is a psychological, sensational feeling that Allah is watching you. Inna Allaha basirun bil-ibad. Allah is watching you. Allah is doing all the activities you do. Then make the best time. Number five, ikhtinamu al-awqat. Make the best use of your time. Be cautious. Tahdhirun. So you should not be preoccupied with unnecessary knowledge. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika al-ilmun la yanfa'. You seek refuge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the knowledge doesn't give any benefit. We are knowledgeable about what this president is doing, the political parties. There will be no benefit for you, dunya al-akhirah. So precision and focus, dabtun wal-itqan, they are very precise, I mean, memorize them and be focused. then mutala'atul kitab, and you should study books. There is a necessity for books. Nowadays, you can choose the internet, the replacement of the books. And number 9, choosing companion. Ikhtiyar sahibi. If you have a good companion who seek knowledge, then you will get benefit from association. And number 10 is ta'adib ma'ash shaykh, and good manners to our shaykh. وَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَقِ الْعَظِيمِ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَهْدِهُ ونشكره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد صادق الوعد الأوعد الأمين وعلى إخوان نبينا والمرسلين رضي الله عن أمهات المؤمنين وآل أهل البيت الطاهرين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning many, many things, and then in his book and his the prophet's the hadith, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to follow, and we should follow, and the best advice to you is to seek knowledge. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ أَمَرَكُمْ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالسَّلَامِ عَلَى نَبِيِّ الْكَرِيمِ فَقَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَةُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. يقول الله تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. اللهم إنا دعونك استجب لنا دعاءنا فاغفر لنا اللهم لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا من في أمرنا. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات أحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقينا عذاب النار. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتديا غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم استر عوراتنا وامن روعاتنا وقفنا ما أهمنا وقينا شر ما نتخوف. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء المنكر والبغي وَعِذْكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. اُذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ يُسِبْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوهُ يَزِدْكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مَخْرَجًا. أَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ عِبَادُ اللَّهِ.